Hey everyone, many of you install the Tizen Brio on your Samsung TV, but there is no app in the Samsung App Store. So how you can install the Tizen Brio? But don't worry, I will tell you how you can install without any hassle. And yeah, you can find all the tutorials on the Tizen Brio official GitHub page. So let's get started. But before we begin, make sure your Samsung TV the Tizen version must have at least Tizen 3.0 or a newer version, and the model must have 2017 or newer version model, otherwise it won't work. And yes, also need a laptop or PC for this. Actually, there are so many ways to do it, but the laptop or PC way is very much easier than other way. First step, you need to connect your TV Wi-Fi to the same network that your PC or laptop is on. I mean, let's suppose you are using the Wi-Fi router or mobile hotspot. Just connect both your TV and PC or laptop to the same network, otherwise it won't connect. Next, open your PC or laptop, then go to the terminal section and type ipconfig. There you note down your IPv4 IP address. Second step, we need to enable developer mode in the Samsung TV App Store. To do that, open your Samsung TV App Store. In the apps panel section, enter the number using your remote. If you have the simple remote, then you just need to use your TV remote keyboard. Now type 5 number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The developer mode pop-off should be appear after you typing the number. Sometimes it won't show up. If that happen, use the up key on your remote. When you enter the app store, just use the up key of your remote, then type the number 12345 and the developer mode should appear. Now as you can see, the developer preview is appear. Now switch on the developer mode. By default it's off, just make sure it's turned on. Now enter the IPv4 address that you noted down from your PC or laptop. Remember, on first step just write the IPv4 address. Now click OK and reboot your TV. Note down, in some cases after rebooting, the developer option might disappear, but don't worry, do the same process again, but this time don't reboot your TV. Now let's move to the third step. We need your Samsung TV's IP address. First, press your settings icon on your remote or go to the settings from your menu. Then here, go to first general section, then network section, then network status. Now go to IP settings. Here note down your TV's IP address because it's important. Fourth step, now this time again we need the PC or laptop. First go to the GitHub page and download the Tizen Brio device manager setup.exe file. Just because we are using on laptop, that's why we need the setup.exe file. Here we need to download it first. Next, install this. Now open the Tizen Brio device manager. You need to go to the connect device section. Here you need to enter the TV's IP address. Remember we note down the TV's IP address before? That we need to enter here. Now click on connect. Boom, your TV is now connected to the Tizen Brio device manager. Here you will see a successfully connected message. Sometime it won't show, but if you wait, it will show automatically. Now go to the device info. Here you will see your Samsung TV's Tizen version. In my case it's 5.5. In your case it might be different. So by this way you will see which Tizen version you are on your TV. Okay, now let's install the Tizen Brio widget from the GitHub page. Here download the latest file. We need this format, Tizen Brio standalone old.wgt. Now come back to the Tizen Brio device manager. Now go to the app section. Here click install app. Choose the Tizen Brew standalone old.wgt and click install. Now wait 5 to 10 minutes. Once it's fully installed, the install icon automatically disappear. Then on the app section, you will see the Tizen Brew next generation 2.0.1. That's the version we just installed. Fifth step, go to your TV, open your app store. You will see the Tizen Brew app on the app store. Now open it. When you open it for first time, it might get so error, but don't worry, let's fix that. Close the Tizen Brew app. Now go to the app store and enable again the developer mode. In the host PCIP, type 127.0.0.1, then reboot your TV by holding the power button for 5 seconds. Now again, open the Tizen Brew app. Boom, this time it opened without any issue. So how's the trick? I hope this trick will help you to solve your issue. And if you have any question related to this topic, just make sure comment down below and I will answer your all question. So see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye.